With Nags. In this video, we're going to see about what are different types of transformation in SQL Server Integration Service. So basically, it is broadly classified into synchronous and asynchronous, and also we can also able to classify it as blocking, non-blocking, and semi-blocking. So these are different types of classification we can do. A transformation. Okay, it's not about control flows. A single transformation in the control flow, that is data flow transformation. And let us try to understand what is synchronous and asynchronous means. Synchronous means the output of a synchronous component uses the same buffer as the input. Say for example, you are getting the input for a transformation. Assume it's a copy column, and the copy column gets input, and it will throw the same number of rows, right? And it can use the same buffer as the input in the output buffer. So that is what reusing of the input buffer is possible, because output of the synchronous component always contain exactly same number of records as the input. So number of records in equal to number of records out, meaning the same example, the copy column, if you get 100 records, the output will have 100 records with the new column. So it can use the same buffer and include the new column there. So that is what a synchronous component is all about. In case of asynchronous component, the output of the asynchronous component uses the new buffer. Why? Because if you do a transformation of your data, then you cannot use the same buffer as the input buffer. Because best example is aggregate, where you get 100 records in as an input to the aggregate transformation. Then in that, the output can be 10 records or 20 records, right? So it's not possible to reuse the input buffer, because the asynchronous component can have more or less output records than the input records. So the same buffer used while extracting the data cannot be used in the asynchronous component. So these are the two classifications of your transformations. So then what is blocking and non-blocking? So you need to understand this concept of synchronous and asynchronous. So it will be very easy to classify a blocking or non-blocking or semi-blocking transformations. So non-blocking means, so it is like streaming transformations. Streaming means the data is flowing through the transformation are calculated in memory and do not require any data from outside resources to transform the data. Basically, it is synchronous transformation. Okay, so the non-blocking, the first one here is non-blocking. It doesn't require any other output memory or output processes. It just gets the data and transform it and sends back as an output. So this is the non-blocking transformations. Okay, so most of the transformations like derived column, copy column, all those things are non-blocking, and it can be considered as a synchronous non-blocking transformations. We have a second category here, semi-blocking asynchronous transformation. Why? Because it requires subset of data to be collected before they can be sent to a destination. The meaning like it cannot do on its own. The input buffer and it while doing the transformation. So only the sampling data can be processed. Then only the output can be sent. Subset of data can be processed and sent. So these kind of operation, the shape of data can change. So pivoting, so those kind of things comes under semi-blocking. We are going to see what kind of transformations are semi-blocking in the next slide. We will see that. fully blocking asynchronous. So which is the slowest, because they require all the data to be pulled from the source before they can be sent to a destination. So all source data must be loaded into memory first. So why I'm saying all this classification? You need to choose appropriate transformation. You need to avoid fully blocking transformations, because it requires all the data pulled, then only the transformation occurs. So let us see what are the transformations or how we can classify the transformations first. Then we can see what are the transformations classified as non-blocking, semi-blocking and fully blocking. Now it's a summarized version of it, synchronous or asynchronous. So all your non-blocking transformations are synchronous. When it is semi-blocking or fully blocking, it is asynchronous, meaning the output buffer cannot be use the input buffer. You have one copy column and the input buffer and output buffer are remains same, then it is non-blocking. There are some transformations that cannot use the your input buffer, because the output records will change, or number of rows will change, the columns may increase. So these kind of things are considered as asynchronous. So these two are asynchronous. So as I said before, number of rows equals number of rows output. This is true, but here it is false. Then must read all input before they can output. No need in these two cases, because you see here, you have assumed you have 1 million records. So it can process 1,000 rows first or 10,000 rows first, then process that record, the output will be sent. Then it is non-blocking. Or a semi-blocking, some cases it will allow, and it is the same case. So you have 1 million record, and every 10,000 records it will process and send to the output. This is possible. Where in case of fully blocking, you see data should be fully read before it got transformed to its output. Example is aggregate. So you cannot aggregate the data without reading all the data. You will miss some of the outputs, right? Say for example, you have 1 million record and you want to group by location. In location you have 10 records. So at the end, from the 1 million record you are going to get only 10 location records. So it has to read all the 1 million records before processing. So this is what fully blocking. So this is what must read all the input. Yes, in this case it should read all the input. So all your input going to reside in the memory. So it is very risky. New buffer created, false. For this, no new buffer. For these two, new buffer is created. New thread created, false, usually true. Then here also true. New thread means the processing flow. Let us try to summarize what are the different transformations. So let us try to see, most of the transformations are non-blocking, no need to worry about it. But some transformations when you use, it will be blocking or semi-blocking. So what it is, so now you see the copy column, data conversion, direct column, these are the transformation we have already seen. Multicast, row count, export column, import column, slowly changing dimension. These are non-blocking transformations, meaning the number of input rows same, output rows will be same, but the thing is like, what happens, it uses the same buffer, input buffer hold 10,000 records, output buffer can hold the 10,000 records. The same buffer can be used for the output also. That is what a non-blocking. Then semi-blocking, you can see the merge join, where it will read all the, it cannot work in a single flow, it has to get some other external or some other flows to do it, and your output records also different in case of pivot and unpivot. So these are semi-blocking, and your output records may be different and it cannot use the same input buffer. Whereas blocking transformation, you see aggregate, fuzzy grouping, sort is also blocking transformation, where you need to get all the records, then only you need to sort it. You need to get all records, then only you need to aggregate. So these are the different kinds of transformations and categorized in non-blocking, semi-blocking and blocking. So let us try to see it in SSIS package.
If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for the notification.
Here we are in SSIS package now, and let us try to open this transformation and check quickly. Here you have a source and you have a destination. What do you mean by input buffer and output buffer? See, while SSIS is executing, assume there are 1 million records, and it will try to fetch in whatever buffer size it try to fit in this particular task, right? It will fetch 10,000 records at a time, and it will process the entire 10,000 records and store it in the, load it in the destination. So this is what input buffer, and when it goes here, the output buffer should use the same input buffer. This is what I mean. So these transformation, data conversion, direct column, copy column, uses the same rows as the number of output rows, same as the input rows. So it will use the same buffer what input buffer uses. That is what I mean. Whereas in case of sort column, you can see all the data to be fetched. You have 1 million records. Assume you don't have a sort. So these 1 million records will be processed based on the buffer size. So at once it fetches 10,000 records, all the 10,000 records will be passed through this phase. Then next 10,000 records will be passed through. Whereas when you use sort, so first you have 1 million records and only 10,000 records will be fetched, then it will block here. Next set of 10,000 records will be fetched, then it will be blocked here. So it requires all the 1 million records to be fetched before sorting. So it is blocking the transform. It is a blocking transformation. That is what we meant. Okay, let us try to run this task and see what happens. Now I hope there is no 1 million records here, just we have very few records, so it will fetch in a single buffer. So I'm trying to run it. I enable data viewer here as well as after the sort, and let's see what happens now. So I started execution. So there are, now you can see what happened. Clicked it, that's okay. Now let us try to go through this package. Now you can see 8161 total records available in the sources, only this much, so it will be fetched in a single buffer. So it is turned into green. Now you can see the same buffer is used, that is why you have same rows of records. Whereas in sort column, so when you have more records, okay, the buffer is only 8169 and there is no more records, so it fetched, it get passed, so it is stopped now. Data viewer, we are viewing this record, so it is not yet gone here, it is still processing. Okay, so when you have more records, say for example another buffer, so another buffer will fetch all these records and it will stop here. So it will keep on fetching all the buffers and stop here. That is what I'm trying to make. So this is blocking and these are not blocking. Okay, I hope you understand the concept behind non-blocking, blocking and semi-blocking transformations, and you need to avoid this blocking transformation whenever it's possible. Let's try to see the performance improvements in our next videos.
If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.